Hello, Falcons. Welcome back to this week's show.
Today we have many exciting segments, including entertainment, sports, man on the street, two news stories, announcements, and ASB updates.
That's right.
And Falcon TV
starts right now. 5, 4, 3, 2. What are you doing this weekend, Maddie?
Probably just gonna watch some movies. I heard there are a lot of new ones.
Do you know which ones are coming out?
No, but I'm sure Nico and Blake do.
Let's go to entertainment with Nico and Blake.
Hello, Falcons. Welcome back to this week's entertainment. Are there any new movies coming out soon?
Yes, Sonic the Hedgehog 3 and The Wild Robot are coming out in 2024.
Those sound like good movies. Also, Moana 2 and a Minecraft movie are also coming out.
I can't wait for those movies. Now moving on to books, a new Dog Man book is coming out soon.
And a new Diary of a Wimpy Kid book is coming out later this month.
That sounds exciting. I can't wait to read those.
Also, some top trending songs are Birds of a Feather, Die with a Smile, and Espresso.
Lastly, there is a local artist that goes to this school named Diego Stolpin. Recently, he made some songs named Chains, Mini Boss, and lastly, Forbidden Orb Hunt.
If you want to listen to his songs, check out his channel on YouTube, Osprey Songs. That's all for this week, Falcons.
Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Nico and Blake. Now I know what to watch this weekend.
Me too.
I don't know if I'll get to watch anything because my dad will be hugging the TV all day watching baseball.
So it's not just my dad that does that?
Apparently not.
Anyways, let's see what other games are going on in sports with Zayden West.
Hello, Falcons. Welcome back to this week's sports update.
We have some exciting new matches coming up this week.
Starting off with MLB.
The MLB World Series kicks off today in LA where the Dodgers take on the New York Yankees.
Also, on Saturday, the Yankees are playing the Dodgers again for the second game.
I wonder who's going to win.
Now moving on to the Premier League.
Liverpool plays Arsenal away from home at the Emirates Stadium on Sunday at 9:30 a.m.
Wow. Also, Newcastle plays Chelsea away from home at Stamford Bridge on Sunday at 9:30 a.m.
I'm looking forward to those games.
Me too. Now, let's move on to the NFL.
For this week, the Chargers play the Saints, the Vikings play the Rams, and many more exciting games.
Also, the Cowboys play the 49ers, and the Bills play the Seahawks, and lastly, the Panthers play the Broncos.
Those are a lot of matches. I'm looking forward to seeing those results.
Yeah, me too.
Now moving on to the NBA.
With the NBA kicking off the regular season this week, there are going to be many exciting games.
Some of it being LeBron's Lakers taking on Devin Booker's Phoenix Suns in LA.
Also, the Warriors play the Utah Jazz in an exciting matchup.
Anyways, that's it for this week, Falcons.
Now back to the anchors.
Now I know I'll never be able to watch the new movies.
Thanks, Aiden West. That was great.
Hey, Olivia, would you rather go into the future or go back in time?
Probably be able to see the future.
I agree with that. Let's see the other Falcons' answers in Man on the Street with Alessia.
What's up, Falcons? Today I'll be asking whether you guys like pumpkin pie or apple pie better. Would you rather eat apple pie or pumpkin pie, and why?
Apple pie, because pumpkin pie tastes like baby food.
Okay, thank you.
See ya.
Would you rather paint a pumpkin or carve a pumpkin?
Carve.
Why?
Because I just like carving pumpkins, and also I'm very terrible drawer, so...
Okay, thank you. Would you rather have mind reading or visions of the future?
Mind reading.
Why?
That's a good question.
Would you rather be a zombie or a skeleton?
I would be a skeleton.
Why?
Because I don't want to be eating people's brains. That's disgusting.
Okay, and then how about you?
I'd rather be a skeleton.
Why?
Because I don't want to eat people's brains either.
Okay, well, thank you. Would you rather wear sports attire or PJs?
PJs because they're comfortable.
Okay.
Yeah, PJs.
Okay, well, thank you guys. It looks like a lot of you guys wanted to wear PJs. Now, back to the anchors.
Those are some interesting answers.
Thanks, Alessia. That was pretty amazing.
I like Man on the Street.
That's cool, Maddie. I do too.
Do you know what else I like?
What?
Food. Oh, and news stories. I heard that Catherine and Alex did a news story called A Taste of Italy.
Really? Let's go check it out.
There are many places where you can enjoy Italian cuisine, such as Vigia Lucci's, Jay's Gourmet, Buca, and more. Foods range from crab cakes to pizza to meatballs to lasagna to penne with salmon and more. Located in Bresci Ranch Village Center is Tommy V's Urban Kitchen Bar. Stop by Tommy V's for delicious, authentic Italian food. Let's go take a look.
So my name is Francisco Montellano. I'm the owner of Tommy V's. And what do? We take care of business. We take care of people, customers. We want to make sure everybody has a great experience trying our food. So Tommy V's, we opened the doors in 2010. And I became owner in 2020. So me and my family, we're the owners of Tommy V's now. It's 2020. And here we are.
Well, I'll tell you, we all go to restaurants because the food is great and the service is great. But the special thing about Tommy V's is you really truly come as a customer and leave as a family member. It's run by a family, so everyone here is committed to the success of the restaurant and taking care of customers. So amazing food, but even more important, amazing people and an amazing atmosphere where everyone feels comfortable and welcome.
As you can see, Tommy V's has it all. Come with people you love to get a taste of Italy for yourself. You won't regret your choice. Don't take my word for it. Come by and try it yourself. With camera operator Alex Tomasi, this is Catherine Lee reporting for Falcon TV.
Thanks, guys. That made me hungry.
Me too.
Have you bought any Boo Games so far? I have.
Yeah, I have, but I don't know when they're coming.
Well, let's go to announcements with Alex to find out.
Hi Falcons, this is Alex Tomasi with your weekly announcements. This week was Red Ribbon Week. I hope we've all had a fun time dressing up to support our school. Boograms closed last Sunday and will be delivered on October 31st to your advisory classes. Be sure to wear your costumes to school on Halloween. Remember, keep it school appropriate and no full face masks. Today is your last day to complete the pumpkin decorating contest. Good luck to everyone. And make sure to stop by the Strawberry Fields for some fun and thrills at the Haunted Corn Maze. Also, web tutoring is launching today during advisory and will continue on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays, taking place in room 1603 and 1605. On October 28th through the 30th, come into the library to play One Piece and find the pirate game. You will guess how many One Piece items are hidden around the library raffle. The winner will get a $10 certificate to the book fair. Speaking of the book fair, it will be held November 1st through the 8th, so head on down to the library next Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday to win a chance for $10 books to the book fair. That's it for announcements. Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Alex.
Now I'm all caught up. Are there any new updates from ASB?
Yeah, I think there are a lot.
Let's go to ASB updates with Ellie.
Hi, Falcons. This is Ellie here with your ASB update for this week. To celebrate Red Ribbon Week, we had fun days to dress up, so I hope you dressed up for this week. Today is Camouflage or Tropical Day, so I hope you're all dressed up in your spirit wear. We are currently in mid-October, and the drawing contest is taking place. This month is spooky season, so draw something spooky. We also have our pumpkin decorating contest, so make sure you decorate a pumpkin for your advisory class. Anyways, I hope you will participate in all of our fun this month. Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Ellie. Now I'm actually all caught up. Wait, are there any news stories?
Yeah, there are. Let's go to Maddox and AJ's news story on the Strawberry Shack.
In-N-Out Strawberry Shack and Chick-fil-A all have decent milkshakes, but one in particular stands out for the rest. What place am I talking about exactly? Strawberry Shack. These desserts are very delightful, but that's not all. They have cheesecake, ice cream, and not, last but not least, their strawberries.
So I'm the co-owner with my father. We have two locations now, one in Carlsbad and one in Oceanside. So I'm running the Carlsbad. It depends on the year. I would say our top three sellers would definitely be our strawberry shake, our strawberry shortcake, and then the Dole soft serve. So the same thing as Dole Whip. We have the pineapple or strawberry flavor, but those would definitely be our top three, as well as the chocolate strawberries. That's a really good question. What I think makes the Strawberry Shack special is it highlights what Carlsbad's really known for. The strawberries are very, very juicy, very nice. It's something that they're seasonally, so it's not grown year-round, where California does grow 88% of the strawberries for the whole nation. They're, in my opinion, some of the best strawberries, and it's something that Carlsbad never really had other than just the fields.
I'd rate it a 10 out of 10. I like how they make it. It tastes good, especially the syrup. South Float. That's my school. This is my first time ever coming.
As you can see, Strawberry Shack is very loved by the community. From their yummy foods to their famous milkshakes, overall, these desserts are very delightful. But don't take my word for it. Come down here to Strawberry Shack with you and your families. With camera operator AJ Radulat, this is Maddox Cardenas reporting for Falcon TV.
Hello, AOMS. For those of you who are 7th graders, there is a program you can apply for called Reading Forward Together.
Hi, my name is Maddie and I'm an 8th grader.
Hi, my name is Vanessa. We are current 8th graders who participated in RFT, Reading Forward Together, last year.
Oh, Reading Forward Together is a partnership between Oliver Oaks Elementary 1st and 2nd graders and our 7th graders at AOMS.
The program is designed to assist 1st and 2nd grade students who would benefit from additional support in reading.
In RFT, elementary students will be given time to read out loud to the 8th, 7th graders.
This will help elementary students with reading fluency and allow for a leadership role for 7th graders.
If you'd like more information or to apply to the program, pick up an application in the counseling office.
What I loved about RFT was that I loved working with the kids and I loved boosting their confidence for reading.
What I loved about it is it didn't just boost your help, it didn't just help you, but it helped them. And they enjoyed it the best. Because I know when you were in second grade, you did not want to read, did you? No. And it like just helps them want to read. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks. Now I'm actually all caught up.
Finally.
Well, that's it for this week, Falcons.
We'll see you next time on Falcon TV.